We're told that because the Houthis, the rebels who have taken over the central part of the country and the capital, control the airport, it is they who required the Marines to give up their weapons at the airport, taking over now the vehicles at the embassy. And we're told by Yemeni officials that they expect the Houthis to go into the embassy compound. So prepare yourself for some pretty difficult images of someone taking over, what is effectively U.S. property abroad. Now, I'm told by a senior U.S. military official that the U.S. embassy personnel, they took all the necessary steps as they left that embassy. That would include destroying documents and computer disks and also disabling any weapons they left behind. But also keep in mind, it's not just visas that an embassy puts out. This is about political contacts on the ground, intel gathering, military cooperation with the Yemenis, which is very key because they're a partner in fighting AQAP, Al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula. This is a real loss. You understand why they did it. It's a volatile situation, but you do lose something not having that diplomatic post on the ground.
Jim, exactly to that point. I mean, this seems like it could be seen as quite a blow to the Obama administration. It's definitely will be used by Republicans to criticize his foreign policy stance, because this, to Yemen and the cooperation with the Yemeni government, was something that the president has held up in terms of kind of successful partnership in taking on terror.
That's exactly right. And look, this is region-wide now, so you have no diplomatic presence, no embassy in Yemen, none in Syria for a number of years now through the civil war. Post Benghazi, nothing in Libya, and also nothing in Somalia for a number of years. All of these places, hotbeds of terrorism. You've got Al-Shabaab here. You have increasingly ISIS in Yemen as well. Sorry, in Libya, I should say, as well. ISIS certainly in Syria, AQAP in Yemen, some talk of some ISIS fighters there. No diplomatic presence. I'm told by U.S. military officials that the counterterror operations will continue. That's drone strikes, et cetera, down here in the south. But, you do lose something when you don't have those key diplomatic relationships, when you're not sharing information with the local government who is in a partner. And now we're seeing this in four of the countries, four failed states that are real threats to U.S. security.